I'd rather keep Beth Rain's company any day.
Hello, Mr. Spaulding. I'm sorry I'm late.
I don't believe it, man. Those Spauldings are gonna leave Beth alone.
Thank you for meeting me here, Beth.
What made you pick company?
Philip used to say it was his favorite hangout. Two of you came here quite often. I thought you'd be more comfortable meeting me here rather than in my home or my office. Would you like something to drink?
No, thank you. I'm fine.
Something to eat, perhaps?
Mm. Hey, I saw you come in. I thought I'd say hello.
Hello, Jack.
Hey.
Excuse me, this is a private conversation.
Yeah, well, I thought maybe the lady might want a drink.
No, thank you.
Oh. Okay, but I'll be at the bar if you change your mind.
I'm sorry. What were you saying?
I wasn't saying anything. But I don't mind if you ask.
Ask about what?
About Philip.
How is he, Beth?
You needn't worry about him. He's managing to keep his life together in spite of what's happened after the wedding.
And how is he doing that?
By making his own decisions and not letting anyone tell him what to do.
Beth, I admire Philip for wanting to stand on his own two feet. But these decisions are going to affect his entire future if you just let me help him.
Do you know how much you hurt him by being involved with Bradley behind his back?
Believe me, Beth, at the time, I really, sincerely felt that I was acting in Philip's best interests.
I believe you. But trying to control Philip isn't going to help him. It's only going to hurt him.
So it would seem.
I know you love Philip. I can see it in your eyes every time you say his name.
Very observant.
I also know something else. He loves you. He's just afraid to trust that love right now because it's betrayed him so many times in the past.
I just wish there was something I could do to change that.
There is. Keep loving him in spite of his rejection. He needs you to support him and encourage all his decisions. If you love him unselfishly this time, in time he may just return that love.
I hope so. I miss my son very much.
I know, Mr. Spaulding, I know.
Lucky to have found you, Beth. You're a very special young lady.
He didn't always feel that way. What changed your mind?
Because of my involvement with your stepfather, I expected you to hate me. But now you seem to be more forgiving than my own son. Why is that?
Violent feelings often bring on violent actions, and I don't believe in either one.
Can I take that to mean that you and Philip have worked things out and you're still planning to be married?
What we want right now is going to have to wait. Philip still has to work things out with Mindy before we can decide on anything else.
Has he made any decisions about the baby?
He wants it. He asked Mindy if we could have the baby when it's born so we could raise it ourselves.
He wants to raise the baby?
Mm-hmm. He's the baby's father. He feels very strongly about that.
What about Mindy? She's the baby's mother. Is she so willing to give it up?
Mindy wants Philip to marry her.
But that's absurd. Philip is in love with you. I mean, it's all well and good for Philip to take responsibility for the child, but that doesn't mean that he has to marry Mindy Lewis. I hope you pointed that out to him.
Philip has to make his own decisions. And he will. He's strong and he knows what he wants. All I can do is understand and support him.
But if, as you say, he wants to raise the child, what's to prevent it from coming between the two of you?
No matter what happens, Phillip and I will always love each other. Nothing can ever change that.
Phillip can't lose you. You're one of the best things that's ever happened to him.
I can't believe you're saying these things to me.
I should have said it much sooner.
I really must be leaving. I want to thank you again for meeting me here, Beth.
I'm so glad we had this talk.
I'd like to know how you and Phillip are doing. Would you mind if I kept in touch?
I'd like that very much.
Good. Take care of yourself. Good luck.
You too.
Hey. You okay?
Looks like you and the King of Springfield are having a pretty heavy conversation.
I'm very sorry for him.
You what? Man, that guy rules this town and everybody in it. And he knows it, man. I mean, he's up on top and everybody else was just crawling at his feet. Oh, no, but not me. No, I only answer to number one. And that's what you gotta do, Beth, if you want to survive in this world. Why don't you get so involved with a bunch of snobs like the Spauldings in the first place? They're not your kind, Beth. They just want to take you for a ride, baby.
No, you're wrong.
Hey, I know why you can't see what they're doing to you. It's because, man, you're too nice. They got the wool wrapped right over your eyes, and you can't see that. But I'll take it all from you, Beth. If you just listen to me. Now, come on. Don't let the Spauldings make a sap out of you.
How dare you talk about Ellen and Phillip in that way? You don't even know them.
The hell I don't. I was in that courtroom, man. I saw Mr. Allen Spaulding in action. That guy's a killer. And like father, like son. I mean, that preppy got baby cakes pregnant and left the class act like you standing at the altar. I could kill him for that.
Stop it. I'm not listening to this.
Why not? Phyllis Spaulding is nothing but a rich jerk old creep who broke your heart, man.
Don't you ever talk about Phillip in that way in front of me again. Not one more word.